Hi, I'm Jess from Local Land Services and I'm here today to talk to you about the National Livestock Identification System. The National Livestock Identification System, or NLIS, is Australia's scheme for identifying and tracing livestock. Being able to trace animals is extremely useful in the event of a disease outbreak or a contaminant. Australia exports to over 100 markets and is one of the world's largest red meat exporters. The NLIS also helps to provide evidence to our trading partners, guaranteeing our food safety standards and keeping Australia's red meat export markets open. There are a few key things to remember to ensure you are playing your part in maintaining the integrity of the system. Make sure your property has a property identification code, or PIC. You can get a PIC from your local land services office, or it can be applied for online. Your property's LPA accreditation also needs to be completed. This must be updated every 3 years and can be done through the LPA website. As animals are bought and sold along the supply chain, they must be identified with approved NLIS devices like these ones. These can be purchased from rural stores or directly from online companies. Cattle that are born on your property will need to be identified with a white breeder device. However, cattle that aren't born on your property will need to be identified with an orange post-breeder device. In most cases, these devices will remain with the animal for the entirety of its life, maintaining lifetime traceability for that individual animal. It is important that the tags are placed in the right ear and positioned towards the centre of the ear. This will aid in the animal retaining the device for life. It is a legal requirement under the Biosecurity Act that every animal is identified with an approved device before they are transported. So always double check every animal before it's loaded onto the truck. It is an offence to remove an NLIS device. You will now need to complete a National Vendor Declaration, or an NVD, before selling your stock. The NVD communicates the food safety and the treatment status of animals as they move along the supply chain, between properties, to sale yards, or to processors. You can complete your NVD by using your NVD book or completing the online printable version. NVDs are a legal document, so it's important that you fill them out accurately and use the correct version of the form. You must ensure that the NVD being used is for the property that the cattle are moving from, that the place that the journey will commence, the cattle descriptions and number of devices, as well as the destination address are all correct. There are a number of questions that must be completed on the NVD. It's important that you read the questions carefully. You can only select one box, and this information is relevant to the entire consignment. For example, question 3 asks if the cattle in the consignment have been owned since birth. If the answer for even one animal is no, then you must tick no for the whole consignment. You can opt to complete two separate NVDs for mixed consignments. The declaration must be signed by both the person in charge of the stock and the transporter. Before the animal leaves, ensure that you have a completed copy of the NVD and that the driver takes their copy as well as the copy for the person receiving the stock. In New South Wales, it's a requirement that all cattle movements be reported to the NLIS database within 2 days, and this step completes the process. If livestock are bought, sold, or moved through the sale yard, the livestock movements must be recorded by the sale yard. For private sales that do not take place via a sale yard, the buyer or the receiver of the stock must record the movement. The vendor or the seller of the livestock is not obligated to record movements off their property, although they may do so if they like. Abattoirs must record movements of all directly consigned livestock. Some stock and station agents also provide a service to their clients to help them with these property-to-property movements. Without these movements being recorded in the database, lifetime traceability and the integrity of the system is lost. Everyone has a responsibility in maintaining the system. It doesn't matter whether you have 10 head or 1,000, trade cattle on a commercial scale, or have a few head just to keep the grass down. Every record is just as important as the next. For further information, contact your local land services office.